Hi, I'm Peter Orker from Peter Orker Piano Tuition, and it's time again for another A to Z of piano composers and pianists. We've reached the letter G today. Well, letter G is the somewhat controversial pianist, Glenn Gould. Gould was born in Canada in 1932 and suffering a stroke in 1982 caused him to die at the tragically early age of 50 after a lifetime of health issues, things like high blood pressure, spinal injury and anxiety. It's been suggested that he may have suffered from a form of autism or from a bipolar disorder, which explains some of his eccentricities, which became his trademark. Well, his life as a pianist was extraordinary, and many regard him as a genius, despite his many eccentricities. These included things like always wearing a coat because he was permanently cold, even in the summer. He also always wore gloves, apart from when he was actually playing the piano. He hated any form of personal physical contact, and he was never married, and it doesn't look as if he was in long-term relationships or anything like that. But he started his career in a conventional manner, playing his first concert at the age of 5. And at 14, he played Beethoven's 4th piano concerto with the Toronto Symphony Orchestra. In 1957, he undertook a major tour of the Soviet Union and even appeared on television in partnership with Leonard Bernstein in 1960. One of the first indications of his expertise in playing Bach, as you will be able to see easily from this short extract. Wasn't that just wonderful? Well, a few years after this, Gould withdrew from performing in public completely, declaring that the conventional concert-style presentation was an anachronism, and dedicating himself to preserving his performances on record. So after 1964, indeed, all of his performances were recorded, and many of these recordings have become classics in themselves, especially his interpretations of Bach. And so I'm going to play you a short clip of film in which you'll be able to see his incredible ability to bring out all the individual contrapuntal lines of music with amazing clarity. Us mere mortals who try to play Bach can only marvel at how he's able to achieve this. However, this clip also brings out one of his musical eccentricities in particular, how he tended to sing along or make other noises while he was playing. This clip was filmed in his home as part of a TV documentary. Amazing dexterity. And I especially love the part where he breaks off from the music, wander over to the window, still humming, and then returning to the piano without missing a beat. Well, the singing, whilst quirky, was only moderately controversial. But where he really ruffled some musical feathers was often in his choices of tempo. which often went against what was considered the correct way to play or interpret a particular piece. To illustrate this, here's Lang Lang playing Mozart's Rondo alla Turca. Pretty fast, eh? And the piece is normally played at that kind of tempo. Now, listen to Glenn Gould's interpretation. Quite a difference. Interestingly, however, Gould's interpretation has been praised by Turkish traditional musicians who say that the slower tempo brings out the Turkish style much better and more effectively than performances at the conventional Lang Lang type speed. Well, you'll have to make up your own mind. I personally find Glenn Gould a fascinating pianist because he has those, he's so individual and has those differences. It just makes him somehow far more interesting to listen to. And that's all for now. I hope you enjoyed my Letter G pianist and that you'll look out for the next video where we'll be reaching the letter H. I wonder who it will be. Well, thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, give me a like, maybe share, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye for now.